Hey, what's up, y'all? Y'all know my slogan. I don't know it all, but I know what I've been through. Now, it seems like your boy Jim Jones and Freddie Gibbs ran into each other last night in Miami, and it seems like it resulted in a little fight. Now, a lot of people are saying, hey, like, what is Freddie Gibbs doing fighting Jim Jones and vice versa? But some of you may or may not know that Freddie Gibbs made a few unkind words about Jim Jones for no apparent reason in 2014. So I guess he had to deal with the consequences. It's being said that your boy actually lost the fight between Jim Jones and his entourage, you know, because they both had their entourages. So we're gonna get into that whole article, but before we do, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time we drop new content. And I swear it's lit here. So join one of the littest gangs on YouTube so you can stay updated with some of the realest content. Now let's get straight into it. Now, Jim Jones and Freddie Gibbs ran into each other in Miami last night, December 14th, resulting in a fight. Now it says here, sources revealed that the pair and their respective crews got into it Monday night with Gibbs and his entourage coming out on the losing end. The clash began after they bumped into one another accidentally at the exclusive Miami eatery Prime 112. Now, Jim Jones and his people were exiting the restaurant as Freddie Gibbs and his crew made their way inside. Jim initiated a conversation addressing some of the negative comments Gibbs has sent his way in the past. Now, one of Jim's entourage is then said to have punched Freddie Gibbs, and he began throwing blows himself. Now, Freddie Gibbs' bodyguard also took some kicks and punches to the face during the altercation. Now, at first when I seen this, I'm like, all right, these guys are too old to be getting into some, oh, he bumped me, he did this little altercation. However, I had to learn that back in 2014, Freddie Gibbs called Jones a wannabe blood gang member when he was asked on Instagram Live by a fan. See? And see what I'm talking about? A lot of these celebrities, man, this is why they need PR. All right, they need PR, because at the end of the day, you know, it's just certain things you don't say, even if you feel it. You a celebrity, you a star, you know, you got certain things going. And even though, like, being a rapper isn't a job, like, you know, your typical 9-to-5, it kind of still is. And anybody else that are rappers are pretty much your coworkers. So, you know, when you got coworkers that you really don't like, but you can't say it because it'll create a hostile work environment, that's pretty much what this is, man. But you got some people, they can't hold their tongue, and they let the fans pretty much hype up a situation. But anyway, and matter of fact, in this case, it wasn't even a fan. It was just Freddie Gibbs blabbering off at the mouth. All right. Now it says here, in the past, Gibbs has spoken out about rappers claiming gangs for the sake of attention and album sales. Gibbs reiterated his statements when it came to Jim Jones and his connection to the Bloods gang. When someone commented about Jim Jones being a vice lord, Gibbs responded by saying, quote, hell nah, he a wannabe blood. Gibbs also reposted a photo of Jones jokingly wearing a waist trainer and said this, quote, damn, so y'all N-words trying to have tiny waist and fat A-words now too? Shaking my effing head, good morning, mother effers. Not long after that whole comment, I guess your boy Freddie Gibbs was shot at while outside a Brooklyn, New York record store. And just hours later, Jim Jones was tweeting about people needing to be careful while they are in Brooklyn. Now, after reports came out about the situation on Vlad TV, Act retweeted the post just 6 minutes later, clowning Gibbs in the process because of their long ongoing feud with each other. Now, Academic said this. He said, quote, WTF, me and him was supposed to have a boxing match. He already caught a case of the beats. What the FFF? Y'all know what it is. Then after that, he said, quote, Freddie Gibbs definitely telling his police officer dad and district attorney brother on Jim Jones. Now, I don't know how true it is, but it's been alleged that Freddie Gibbs actually does have a father that was a police officer, and he has a brother that is, you know, a DA. So it makes you think about these guys, you know, and they gang lives, and I don't know, but it is what it is. Now, after that whole situation, DJ Academics also went to tweeting Freddie Gibbs himself, asking him if he's okay. All right, now, to be honest with you, in my personal opinion, Gibbs is to blame for this Because if you want to make comments like that and make jokes online and question someone's status or gang status, then you got to wear that and you got to be ready for whatever comes with it. All right. Although I can't lie, that waist trainer picture was a little too crazy, but hey, now I mean, now he could say that you got beat up by a guy that wears a waist trainer. But anyway, you got to be ready at all times if you're going to talk how he was talking. Also, I advise him to get new security, because if they getting hands and feet put on them as well, then there's no sense in having them as security. How you going to feel safe as an artist when the people that's supposed to be protecting you is getting hands and feet put on them? All right. And not for nothing, I'm starting to see why these rappers love shooting, matter of fact. Because it seems like none of them could fight. I ain't gonna lie. None of them could fight. And to his discretion, though, I must say, if you're familiar with the guys Jim Jones having his entourage, then you understand what's going on. If you know, you know. Now, as far as DJ Academics, well, Academics is doing what Academics do. And pretty much, he's doing what anybody would do in his position if someone you've been going back and forth with actually ends up getting beat up. So I don't have much to say about that. As far as Freddie Gibbs, I don't know if the embarrassment or the news was too much for him, but he deactivated his Instagram. All right. And last but not least, things like this are dangerous, because when you have a reputation to uphold like Freddie, being this gangster, drug dealing street guy that you portray in your music, and something like this happens, your pride gets hurt, your ego get hurt, you start seeking or want to seek revenge, because now you feel like you got a point to prove. You know what I mean? You want to get back. So I don't see anything positive coming out of this situation. Honestly, I feel like it could probably get worse in the future, but I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Now, that's pretty much all I got, man. Y'all make sure y'all like, comment, share, and subscribe. Hit that bell so you're notified every time we drop new content. And remember, as long as y'all keep on watching, I'm gonna keep on dropping. And I'm out.